All right, time to draw another rainforest animal, and this one is one of my favorites. This is the biggest cat of the Amazon rainforest, the jaguar. I love drawing mammals, and I love drawing big cats, so I'm excited to help you with this one. Now, our jaguar is going to be sleeping on a tree, so I'm going to start by drawing the tree. As always, I'm going to go kind of fast so that you can pause and catch up when you need to. So our tree, you've noticed that my paper is portrait. Our tree is going to start at the bottom and go up until about the middle. And it's going to be pretty thick because it's a jaguar sleeping on it. And actually, yeah, let's put it right there. And they're heavy things, so we need a pretty hefty branch. Now, the jaguar is an organic animal, so we're going to make it out of round shapes. I'm going to start by choosing where I want the head and draw just a circle for my head. Okay, and now I'm going to go ahead and draw a bigger oval shape for the bulk of the body. It's laying, so it's going to be lined up about with the head. Okay, and now that's most of the body. If I was drawing the jaguar standing, I would probably specify where's the rib cage and where's the hips. But because it's a cat, if you've ever seen a cat, when they lay down, they kind of like puddle into themselves. And a jaguar does that as well. So what I'm going to do next is put in general shapes for where the limbs are. And remember to draw light until you get it right, because these shapes are going to be erased. All of them. Or at least most of them. So we're going to have an oval back here because I want the leg sitting up on top of the branch. We're going to have an elbow here, a paw hanging down here. We're going to have another paw. Ooh, I should make my branch a little thinner because I want a visible paw on the bottom. Now it's still thick enough that I can have my jaguar, but ooh, that's going to be cute. There's a little paw hanging down there. And the other leg wouldn't be visible because it would be behind our friend the jaguar. We'll put in our tail later, so now let's start connecting things. I don't want to do a straight across line, although that would look okay. I'm going to add a little bit more of a bump to imply that there's a muscle right there, okay? And I'm going to put another circle, I forgot this one. Right here, this is where, speaking of muscle, made me think of muzzle. So that's what this is going to become. This is going to become the muzzle. So let's keep adding in our general sense of form. I'm going to have right here, you don't have to draw this line. I'm putting it into as I think, but this is where my muscles would line up. And then we would have our shoulder line up with the elbow. The elbow would curl back down to the paw. Notice how I'm running outside of the circles. When you draw and you're using these shapes, you want to think about it like a bicycle. And the bicycle has the gears and the chain that goes outside of the gears. That's very important as you draw animals with round shapes. So next I'm going to connect from here to there. Notice how it's slightly curving in. It's not a straight line. That's important. And this is going to lay flat along the tree. Okay. And now let's turn this oval into our back leg. I'm actually going to end up leaving a lot of that oval. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a curve and a bump for our back paw, and then another curve because we need the body to connect. Remember, you're drawing shapes, not lines. The difference is that a shape is connected and whole. So we need our leg to connect to the branch. Okay, looking pretty good so far. I think it's time that we can go ahead and start adding some details to the face a little bit. I'm going to come over here. Sorry for that interruption. We're going to go ahead and start with our ears. So our ears are going to be round, but we don't want Mickey Mouse. Instead, what we want to do is have a straight line, a curve, and then a straight line. Okay? It's a little bit more complicated than that, but I'm sticking with simple shapes so that we can get this drawn in 15 minutes. And then we're going to have our other side with the same general shape. Okay. Now, for the face, inside circle, you're going to do an upside down triangle nose. And the big cats, they're slightly dipped in. I'm going to come bring this in. Do you see how it's not quite a triangle? It's almost like a heart. That's honestly more accurate to a big cat's nose. And I'm going to go ahead and erase these lines that I have in here. That's why I drew them so lightly. Put the line that connects the nose to the mouth. And then we're going to have a two diagonal lines come down on the side to the muzzle. So now our muzzle is a little too circly. This looks too much like a bear and not enough like a jaguar. So what I'm going to do is come up from that side. Do you see how I'm going at a diagonal line up? Let's bring you forward more since this is so detailed. Okay. Okay. So we've got it up from the sides, and then it's going to come in. Draw very lightly for this part, because you're probably going to want to erase it and redraw it every once in a while. Now, this is where the line where the muzzle meets the eyes. So we're going to have a circle right there on both sides. Oh. And inside the circle is our pupil. Now, I do not have room for cute little eyes. In fact, my eyes look kind of scary. But hopefully, since you're drawing with a pencil, which is way smaller than a marker, you have room. We're going to go ahead and add these lines. And before I get carried away and add more details on the face, I need to make a more realistic body with less of these crazy lines everywhere. So, we're going to go ahead and erase some of the guidelines that we put in. Watch which lines I erase. I'm going to erase these ones. Basically anything that overlaps. Think about your animal. Think, this is a leg. What does a leg actually look like as you erase your guidelines? And sometimes you'll want to keep some of the guidelines. Like, I like that right there because it makes it look a bit muscly. Just going to put that in. Oh, I like that. So I'm leaving that line. I'm leaving this. Notice how I leave that whole big circle because that's kind of how the cat legs work. But I'm going to erase this part, erase there, erase this. Okay. And erase this little circle around the paw. Good. Now we can start adding more details. So first detail I'm going to add is a little bit of a crease right there in the nook of the leg and the paws. To make a paw, I'm going to make this curved circle right on the edge of where the foot is. Down here, I'm going to have three lines so that I have four toes. Notice how they're all diagonal. On this side, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to curve them a bit more because this is the underside of the paw. So I can actually go ahead and put in the toe beans. Oh, so cute. And just a teeny tiny toe bean right there. I like that. Let me show you what I did. Oh, precious. And let's put in our tail. So my jaguar's laying on the branch. The tail would be, I would love to have the tail wrap around the tree. I think that'd be pretty. I'm not sure I can, but let's give it a try. So the tail's going to come off of the back. So notice how I'm drawing in my mind along the back, ghosting over the leg. And then where it comes to the white space again, I'm going to start my tail. And then make sure it's thick enough to be a jaguar tail. And it's going to go down around the tree. And, I don't think it would be visible, actually. So maybe instead what I'm going to do is have a curl up right at the top. Not my favorite tail. No, I'm going to try again. I don't even mind that you're seeing me fail. Because instead what you're seeing is that I drew light. And I didn't get it right, so I'm going to try again. Let's see. Would it look better if it goes on top of the branch? Yes, that looks better. Okay, so now I'm happy with my tail. And so now I can erase the lines that the tail would cover up. I ended up going with the same shape, but instead of having it behind the branch like this foot, it's on front. And now comes the fun part, the jaguar spots. Okay, now do not just go crazy, because jaguars, leopards, and cheetahs all actually have unique spots. So when you think of an animal with a dot spots like this, that's how a cheetah looks. Jaguars and leopards have spots that are more like you take spots and you group them together, and then you take more spots and you group them together. So like this looks like three dots. This looks like three dots that are kind of smushed, and then we push them together, and this would actually have a different color in the middle. And this is a leopard spot. Jaguars, what they did was they took the leopard spot and they went one further and put little dots in the middle. Now, sometimes it's just one dot, sometimes it's a bunch of little dots. But let me show you on my phone. I know this isn't very professional, but I'm not a YouTuber. So this middle section, cheetah. This side section, leopard. This most complicated one, jaguar. Aren't you glad we're doing the most complicated one? So, as you are drawing your jaguar and you're putting in your spots, one of the good things to remember is that jaguar spots are bigger than cheetah spots. They take up big chunks. So I'm going to start by drawing lightly, drawing these big spots. Big spots. Looks quite comical, honestly. It looks like I'm making a joke how big these spots are going to be. And then, but I'm drawing super duper lightly, because once I've drawn the spots, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make my wibbly wobbly, like an awkward shaped outside with my spot in the middle. And that's how I'm going to make my jaguar spots. I'm going to do another one so you can watch. I'm going to go on that side, wibbly wobbly, kind of do circles with my pencil. Put one or two in the middle. I'm going to erase these other lines that I don't need. Then when I get to coloring, the inside of the spot's going to be a darker, lovely gold color as opposed to the yellow of the rest. And the fun thing about jaguars is they seem so complicated with their spots, but they're really trying to help you out, because on the limbs and on the face, they simplify and they just turn into big black dots. Big black dots that get really small as they get closer to the edge of the paws. Okay, which, if you want to add claws, be my guest. The face and the tail are a bit more complicated, so I'm going to talk about those before I finish any other spots. The face doesn't really have any spots in the nose except for the spots where your whiskers would be, and the nose itself should be dark. And then up until the eyes, that's when we actually start getting those spots. And they're pretty small. The jaguar also has these lovely white rings around its eyes, which you can add. And the spots that go around the mask. Oh, that's so pretty. And so they don't have the big complicated spots, just simple ones. On the tail, you're going to see spots that are just like the body spots. Just like the body spots on the tail, all the way to the end. Now the tail, though, is a small section, so these spots themselves sort of become the end of our jaguar. I'm going to pause, finish drawing some spots, so you can get an idea of how this is going to look. I'm satisfied with my jaguar. I'm going to hold it here so you can take a look at it, see anything you might be missing. I added some details with whiskers and with ear fluff, as well as finishing up those spots. Again, they got smaller as I got closer to the face and closer to the edges of the paws. And this is a great project for coloring. Great project for colored pencil, especially because you can do the whole thing with your yellow and leave it white on like the belly, and then go over the yellow with a more goldish, orangish color inside the spots. And that yellow is going to pop out beautifully against a green background. So, please have fun. Do enjoy a jaguar. I love a good jaguar. And I hope to see your finished project later.